is the difference between research and innovation?
The distinction that's classically made isn't really between research and innovation, but between basic research and applied research. And the idea, to the extent that it has any basis in reality, the idea of basic research is that it's research that is conducted purely for the joy of the inquiry itself and for the advancement of knowledge in a particular field. Applied research, on the other hand, is usually meant with a particular sort of goal or outcome in mind. Either you are specifying a type of product or the qualities of that product or a service that you're hoping to achieve and figuring out a pathway to delivering those products. So that's those are the two distinctions, I think, that are made in the minds of funders in terms of the different tools that they're going to use to actually try to achieve them. In one, it's funding without a particular goal in mind, and so you're sort of ex ante providing funds with the hope that you will have an outcome that is as yet unspecified. In the other one, you have sort of an ex post idea of what it is that you're trying to achieve, and some pathway that you're hoping you're going to be able to follow in order to achieve it.
What's the role of public funding in those stages of research?
This gets to a very fundamental question: is what is the role of government in funding innovation, and which of these two sets of types of research and development should the government be involved in, and why? What is the outcome? And it wasn't right now the at least in the United States, the federal government funds about a quarter of all research. Of all of the research funding, that is expended by either the private sector or the government, a quarter of it is government funded, and about half of that is for basic research, and half of that is for development work. So, but the real question is this: what is it that the government hopes to achieve?
So the question to ask our politician is: do you care about having more Nobel Prize winners or more large corporations that reinvest in the ecosystem, our anchor customer, anchor investors? And the answer is not one or the other. I think it's both. But that really sometimes it makes people focus, because Canada, for example, has been very much on basic research for a long time. And with us, especially on the venture side, saying we need the involvement of the government, we need the right incentive, because we don't have many corporations doing pitching in. And philanthropy, again, another way to intervene when we are at the beginning of the food chain, is still not developed in Canada. So it depends also where how developed you are as an ecosystem.
I think it's very important to have an ecosystem that fosters both basic research and also applied research. I would like to give an example from Germany. So we have two large research association research societies. One is the so-called Max Planck Society, which more or less focuses on basic research. And then we have the Fraunhofer Society, which focuses very much on applied research. And the Max Planck Society is more or less to 80-90% publicly funded, and 10-20%, well, they have to raise from like private funds. On the other hand, the Fraunhofer Society is only publicly funded to about 20-25-30%, and for the rest of it, they have to acquire private funding. Both of these organizations, societies, are seen as an important tool to stabilize the ecosystem in Germany, to have some basic research, but also to have some applied research. And Fraunhofer institutes usually work quite intensively together with companies. So this is seen as a major tool.
The world at the beginning of the 20th century was a world where entrepreneurship was almost entirely privately funded. Universities did very little research, and the research that they did was not publicly funded. We then, over the course of the middle of the century, with the two world wars, came to a system where the U.S. government, at least in the States, was very involved in both applied research and basic science, and the with the The late 20th century and a discussion about competitiveness of industry, there was more push being put into the translation of basic research for its use and uptake by the private sector. But certainly that debate about what the government ought to be doing and where it ought to be putting its funding, not even mentioning the debate about how much of it should be in health, how much should it be in aeronautics, how much of it should be in electronics, that debate is still one that is roiling our discussions about what the government ought to be spending time on and putting its funding in.